My name's Ken Fortier. I am a technical product manager here at CNC Software. I've been here for 23 years, and the team that I'm working with is responsible for the simulation area of the product, including backplot verify, machine simulation, as well as some of the new projects that we're working on for updating the new machine group setup and job setup. So we have a special task to do that as well. Yeah, customer feedback is invaluable to us because we can't do anything without it. We try to come up with ideas that we think will help our customers solve the problems they're trying to solve, but we can't really get it right without their input. We can get close, we can try our best, and that's kind of what we do with some of these new projects is we'll give it our best shot based on our experience and our knowledge, and then we'll hand it out to our customers to look at in the beta sites, and then they can tell us what they like about it, what they don't. We adjust it. We love that feedback because we want it to be right when we go out the door, and we don't want to have any issues that our users are going to run into, especially with new features and new additions to the software. The GPU processing feature that we've added, or the ability, has been asked for years and years and years, mostly from our mold making customers who have massive parts with massive tool paths. So for this initial release of the GPU processing, it supports the mill product for the 5-axis and 3-axis tool paths. And it increases the speed in some cases on huge files with thousands and thousands of moves by upwards of, you know, 5 or 6 times the speed increase. And that performance is really what those mold makers have been asking for. You know, we always want speed. We always want more features, but speed is always a real concern for our users, and this is something that addresses that directly based on that feedback. I mean, we've been seeing CPU speed increases throughout, you know, the last 10, 15 years, and that's kind of slowed down. So using the GPU is the only next step that we can do to get some more processing power. The software, you don't need to do anything. It's enabled by default. If it detects that you have a GPU that's capable of processing data, we will use it. If it doesn't support it, we won't use it. And the option is also available to turn it off if you choose to always not have it processing with that GPU. So it's up to you. In the simulator, we've implemented a lot of features that help people with large amounts of data. Obviously, the GPU processing is one. The append operation allows us to select an operation, process it, see the results on the screen, and then select another toolpath and process just that additional toolpath. We don't have to regenerate the entire session again. And that's huge, especially for the mold making industry where, you know, it could take them 2 or 3 hours to do a simulation on a single toolpath. And to have to process that a second time just because you wanted to add a few drill operations to it is foolish. So being able to do that really enhances the experience for people that are doing a lot of what-if scenarios. And that's typically what happens in a mold type of environment, or any environment for that matter. We also have the bookmarks feature that we've added, and we've made some changes and enhancements in there as well. That allows us to add material back at certain locations or certain decision times in the process. So you could have a bookmark that's created after every operation so that you can replace the stock at any of those locations and go back to that point in time and then continue on from there. So, you know, we have a lot of features that really work with large amounts of data that we're trying to deal with and to make it a better experience for our users. We had a lot of requests for adding collision detection types, like stop at an operation, stop at a specific ID number, stop on a crash or a proximity alert. So there's a lot of things that we can stop at. We're trying to be an engineering tool to our users and not just, you know, a feature. And what makes sense to that engineering user is that they need to get information out of that system. They want to see where those collisions are. They want to turn them on and turn them off as they're moving through the process. And in order to set those, we had the users go back to the backstage menu. And in order to go back to the backstage menu and make a change, you have to restart your simulation. So it was something that wasn't right at your hand, that in the interface, just click and continue on and have the collision detection turned on. So we moved all those features that were in the backstage menu onto the interface on the verify tab. So now you can On the fly, just turn on collision detection for any feature that you want that we support. So, you know, tool versus stock, tool versus machine components if you're in the third tab, the machine simulation tab. So there's a lot of power there so that they don't have to stop their workflow, go back to the backstage menu, restart, and then continue on. So we're trying to make things a lot more efficient while you're in that simulation session. Customers have asked for MasterCam to be more automated. And as a company, we've strived to move towards that automation goal. In order to automate this part of the process, dealing with tool paths and setting up your machine and your machine group setup, we needed to redesign how it worked. We needed to be able to support multiple stocks. We need to be able to set up exactly what's going to happen on the job before you get into simulation. We want to be smarter about having the machine definition know what machine's going to be used as opposed to having to select it at runtime. So redesigning this is step one in a bigger process towards automation. We had several sessions before we started the project to define what we wanted the initial machine group setup to be. And then during the process, we had additional beta sites that were working with it, and we were getting feedback from that. We're not making change for change's sake. We're making changes to make it better. What we've done is we've taken some of the best pieces of the software for defining stock. People might not be aware, but there's probably six different ways that you can define stock in MasterCam. And we've taken all those features and combined them into the machine group setup and have the best of everything in there. You can set up your tools. You can set up the machine that you're going to use for simulation. You can set up your post-processing. You can define work holding fixtures and move those fixtures around and have the placement of the stock on the machine a little bit more automated. This is the first step. It's an important step because we needed to set up the background database structures to be proper before we move forward. So there was a lot of work that was done behind the scenes that isn't shown to the user but is happening. So it's a big step. It's important. We're continuing the work on it, and we have a lot more to do, but we're pretty happy with what we've got so far. This is MasterCam 2023.